what can we do when possible blindness occur? Firstly, we do have a window period of about 60 to 90 minutes where there is still a better chance lack of oxygen can be reduced so that the cell damage in the retinal can be reduced. And this is what we call the golden window period. It is about 60 to 90 minutes. However, I will emphasize that the earlier it is, the better the chances are. What are the things that a doctor can do? Number one, when a customer or patient feedback to you, her eyes has blindness or she's unable to see, like mentioned in the video with Esther, when she feedback to the doctor that, hey, my eyes can't see, the doctor dismiss it as possible side effect of local anesthesia. Local anesthesia usually may cause, although very rare, temporary blindness. It is not serious. However, blindness due to Juvelook volume or fillers is serious. Therefore, as a doctor, we need to take that possibility as a much more serious possibility, which means that we have to activate all the rest of the treatment, oral or topical eye drops, as a form of precaution to reduce the chance of blindness. Firstly, we need to do ocular massage. Ocular massage may reduce the pressure in the eye, and therefore, when intraocular pressure drops, there is a hope that the blood vessels in the retina will increase. And when it increases and it dilates, there is a better or less chance that the ischemia will destroy the retinal cells. Thus, blindness may be less affected. Number two, we should inject a lot of very generous things that can dissolve the fillers, like hyaluronidase. Although Juvelook Volume is a polymer, it has a combination of HA, hyaluronic acid, and their polymer, PDLLA. We can inject hyaluronidase, hopefully to at least dissolve the HA component and hopefully increase the possibility of reperfusion or more reperfusion. Thirdly, generous amount of timolol, eye drops that reduces intraocular pressure again. And when intraocular pressure is reduced again, perfusion will increase and therefore retinal cells damage can be reduced. Lastly, oral medication like aspirin, which is a blood thinner, may reduce the embolism caused by the injection. Another medication that we can use is acetazolamide, which also reduces intraocular pressure. And that in turn will also reduce ischemia. Safety is our first and topmost priority. We do extensive research on the product we wish to use. We do not just jump onto the bandwagon, even though the product is trending, highly profitable, or lack competition because many injectors do not use. To us, safety comes before profit because we are here to do long-term work for our patient, and our patient is our utmost, highest priority and responsibility.